Lakes Stadium, ladies and gentlemen. This evening's ECFA Men's Premier Cup Final between the teams of Dow College in Swansea and York College. Run through the team lineups for Dow College at Swansea. One goalkeeper, Luke Harris. Number two, Jacob Gray. Number three, Harry Lawson. Number four, Tim Georgievski. Number five, Tyler Elwood. Number six, Liam Croucher. Number seven, Colin Morgan. Number eight, Curtis Rees. Number nine, Jack Todd. 10, Callum Solomons. Number 11, Danny Williams. Substitutes, number 12, Harrison Davies. Number 14, Ewan McNabb. Number 15, Darrell Hughes. 16, Finlay Capper. Number 17, Luke Roberts. For your college, there's one or two number changes from those printed in your programmes. Number one, Locke. Number two, Harry Shepherd. Three, David Barber. Number four, Kieran Holmes. Number five, Owen Marshall. Number six, Joe Dunnett. Number seven, Donald Chulila. Number eight, Angus Richardson. Number nine, Marcel Chigamuria. Number 10, Rob Hutton. Number 11, Jack Simpson. Substitute number 12, Fraser Hanson. 14, Elliot Anderson. 15, Matthew Savage. 16, Tom Pollock. And number 17, Sean Hunter. Again, to draw to your attention the fact that there is a refreshment kiosk open. Scoreboard end of the stadium, right hand side is looking out, and at pitch level, hot pies, snacks, drinks, and light refreshments available. College, number 11, Jack Simpson.
Come on, Daddy! Come on, Dad! Thank you. Go! Thank you. Steve for hosting us here tonight. Just to briefly introduce myself, I'm Lauren Sullivan. I'm National Football Development Manager for AOC Sport. And it's a great privilege of mine to welcome our England Colleges men's and women's national representative team. Please give them a round of applause. I'm sure you'll agree it's been a brilliant first half of college football. The Premier Cup obviously represents the pinnacle of our cup competition, and our National Colleges representative teams represent the pinnacle of the college game. It's a great achievement to have represented your country at both domestic and international fixtures. And we've got this evening both men's and women's players from this current season and also our alumni from last season joining us here tonight to receive their international caps. So please give them a big round of applause as they receive their international caps this evening. If I could just introduce Marcus Kingwell, our Managing Director at AOC Sport, and he will be presenting the international honours caps this evening. And I'd also like to introduce Bob Buckingham, Jill Buckingham and Holly Buckingham, who will be presenting, in memory of Luke Buckingham, the Luke Buckingham Player of the Year Award. And I'll speak a little bit more about that a little bit later on. I've had the privilege of working with these players throughout the season, and I can confidently say that they've represented their college, themselves and their country to an outstanding level, and it's been an absolute pleasure working with each and every one of you. Our men's team travelled out to Italy back in March, played a range of fixtures, learned a lot about how European referees referee the game and manage the game in a different manner. And our women's team are heading out to Portugal at the end of this month. So without further ado, if I can start by welcoming Niamh Lane to receive her award. Give Niamh a round of applause. Give a round of applause coming, please. Charlotte Newsham, representing Queen Stanley College. Brennan McCarlin, representing Accrington and Rosendale. Olivia Wilkes, representing Accrington and Rosendale. Charlotte Smith, representing Richard Hughes College. Representing York College. Katie Samuels, representing Accrington and Rosendale College. Rosanna Todd, representing York College. Shania Hayes, representing Solihull College. And Emily Joyce, representing Solihull College.
Please give all of our players a huge round of applause for a fantastic
special one for me because I've had the pleasure of working with Luke Buckingham for about 5 years. Luke started out as a player for his college. He represented Bridgewater College and also played for Bridgewater Town. He then went on, he was a goalkeeper. He then went on to be goalkeeper coach for our national team. So he was working alongside these types of players, supporting them, developing them, helping them to become better players, but also better people. I think what I learned most from my time working with Luke was the values and the morals that he stood for. He was a man that, the quote and the hashtag that follows him around now is "better never stops." He's someone that always strove and strives for better performance. And he instilled that in everyone that he worked with and every life that he touched. He had a really hard battle with leukemia. And I know that there's lots of fundraising that happens in his memory to make sure that his legacy lives on. And so it's a great privilege and pleasure of mine, knowing Luke really well. I know he wasn't just a colleague, he was a friend. And he supported this programme and enabled it to improve year on year. And we certainly wouldn't be where we are now if it wasn't for Luke's legacy and passion. Better never stops and that legacy that he's instilled into everyone that he's worked with. So it's a great privilege and pleasure to be presenting this award this evening to a player that's demonstrated those values day in, day out, in every game, in every fixture. He's led the team, he's stepped up to captain the side when we were out in Italy. He's a player that's had huge leadership both on and off the pitch. He's someone that constantly asks for feedback and how he can improve his performance. And he's been an absolute pleasure to work with this season. So, Max, if I could please welcome you up to receive the Luke Buckingham Player of the Year Award, Max Harris from Hartley College. I'd also like to say a massive thank you to the Buckingham family for coming out to present this evening. It means a lot for you to be here. And I'd also, one final round of applause, if I could invite our coaching staff just to take a step out. I know Simon Lees is also in the stand. Our national team runs on the basis of hard work and graft by a team of outstanding volunteers. Luke was one of these volunteers that made this programme possible. So I'd like to just publicly say a huge thank you to you for all the work that you put in. And we're looking forward to building on another successful season for the year beyond and inviting what will be our alumni back this time next year to be part of this annual awards process. So please give it up for our England Colleges national team one more time. Thank you for being and enjoy the second half.
Come on, come on. Move it. Pick that up.
Yeah!
Come on, see you again.
So, Daddy! Another run!
Well on top, yeah.
Yeah.
Responsibility, look around!
Swansea, 10, Gary Williams.
Thank you. One more minute. Just like that.
Thank you.
York College, number 15, Matthew Savage. Sorry, I'm just getting it on the scoreboard at the moment.
Yeah!
scores level at 3-3. We now have extra time, 30 minutes of extra time.
There's nothing to do. Check. I want. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah!
because I'm not sure quite how to follow that performance out there. I think you'll all agree that what a cup final, you know, an epic game, a team that comes back half time, you didn't know which way it was going to go, went right down to the wire. You know, what a display of college football. And can you please just join me in commending both teams and the spirit in which that game showed. They've been fantastic hosts. Also to the FA for their continued support, and also to our sponsors, to Molten, to Future Elite Sports, and all of the partners that have joined us here today. It's been great to have you here to watch such an epic game of football. Now, without our referees, football simply wouldn't run. So if I could please invite our four officials to receive their medals, and please give them a big round of applause for the way that they've managed to get us there. please congratulate the champions of the Premier League Cup final.